Dear students, today we are going to discuss exponents and powers of class 8 mathematics. You have already learned about exponents in your previous classes. In this class, you will revise what you have learned and learn more things. Let us see what are exponents and powers. When we multiply any number several times by itself, it becomes the power of that number. That is, if you multiply a n times, a multiply a multiply a, if you multiply it n times, it becomes a to the power n, where a is known as the base and n is known as the exponent. For example, if you multiply 2 5 times, it becomes 2 to the power 5, that equals 32. That means 32 is the 5th power of 2. Now, powers with negative exponents. As we have positive exponents, negative exponents also exist. That can be defined as a to the power minus m equals 1 by a to the power m, where m is a positive number. For example, 3 to the power minus 2 equals 1 by 3 square equals 1 by 9, or 2 to the power minus 4 equals 1 by 2 to the power 4 equals 1 by 16. Also, for any rational number, p by q, p by q to the power minus m equals q by p to the power m. For example, 2 by 3 to the power minus 3 equals 3 by 2 to the power 3. Laws of exponents. Both positive and negative exponents hold the laws of exponents. They are, first one, a to the power m multiply a to the power n equals a to the power m plus n. For example, 2 to the power 3 multiply 2 to the power 2 equals 2 to the power 5. Next, a to the power m divided by a to the power n equals a to the power m minus n. For example, 2 to the power 3 divided by 2 to the power 2 equals 2 to the power 1. Next, a to the power m whole to the power n equals a to the power m multiply n. For example, 2 to the power 3 whole to the power 2 equals 2 to the power 3 multiply 2 equals 2 to the power 6. Fourth one, ab to the power m equals a to the power m multiply b to the power m. For example, 6x to the power 2 equals 6 square x square. Next, a by b to the power m equals a to the power m divided by b to the power m. Example, 3 by 2 to the power 3 equals 3 to the power 3 divided by 2 to the power 3. 6, a to the power 0 equals 1. For example, 4 to the power 0 equals 1. 10 to the power 0 equals 1. Any number to the power 0 equals 1. Now let us solve some problems based on these laws. First of all, evaluate 3 by 5 to the power minus 2. that equals 5 by 3 to the power 2 by the definition of negative exponents equals 5 square by 3 square equals 25 by 9 or 2 whole 7 by 9. Now simplify 4 to the power minus 1 minus 5 to the power minus 1 whole square into 5 by 8 to the power minus 1, which equals 1 by 4 minus 1 by 5 to the power 2 multiply 8 by 5 to the power 1 equals 1 by 20 whole square into 8 by 5 equals 1 by 20 into 20 multiply 8 by 5 equals 1 by 250. Next question, find the multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 2 to the power minus 4 whole to the power 1 by 2. For finding out the multiplicative inverse, first of all we have to simplify this. So this equals 2 by minus 3 to the power 4 to the power 1 by 2. That equals 2 by minus 3 to the power 4 multiply 1 by 2 equals 2 by minus 3 to the power 2. Now, we know that the multiplicative inverse of a to the power m equals a to the power minus m. So multiplicative inverse of two by minus 3 whole square equals 2 by minus 3 to the power minus 2. That is 3 by minus 3 by 2 to the power 2 equals 9 by 4. So 9 by 4 is the multiplicative inverse of the given expression. Now another question, express 16 to the power minus 2 as a power with a base 2. So 16 to the power minus 2 equals 2 to the power 4 to the power minus 2. We know that 2 to the power 4 is 16, which equals 2 to the power 4 multiply minus 2, that is 2 to the power minus 8. So that is the form with the base 2. Our next question is, write exponential form with positive exponent. So the given question, 2 by 7 whole square multiply 7 by 2 to the power minus 3 divided by 7 by 5 to the power minus 2 whole to the power minus 4. That equals 2 by 7 whole square multiply 2 by 7 to the power minus to the power 3 divided by 7 by 5 to the power minus 2 multiply minus 4 equal to 2 by 7 to the power 2 plus 3 divided by 7 by 5 to the power 8, which is equal to 2 by 7 to the power 5 multiply 5 by 7 to the power 8, which equals 2 to the power 5 by 7 to the power 5 multiply 5 to the power 8 divided by 7 to the power 8. That equals 2 to the power 5 to the power 8 divided by 7 to the power 5, 7 to the power 8. That is equal to 2 to the power 5 to the power 8 by 7 to the power 13, which is the required answer. Another question. Write in exponential form with a negative exponent. Minus 7 whole cube multiply 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 9 divided by minus 7 to the power 10 equal to 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 3 multiply 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 9 divided by 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 10 is equal to 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 3 plus minus 9 divided by 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 10. That is equal to 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 12 divided by 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 10. That is equal to 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 12 plus 10. That is 1 by minus 7 to the power minus 2. So that is an exponential form with the negative exponent. Next question. 3 to the power minus 2 whole square multiply 5 square to the power minus 3 multiply t to the power minus 3 whole square whole divided by 3 to the power minus 2 whole to the power 5 multiply 5 cube whole to the power minus 2 multiply t to the power minus 4 whole cube. We had to simplify this expression using the laws of exponents. So 3 to the power minus 2 whole square equals 3 to the power minus 2 into 2. 3 to the power minus 4 multiply 5 to the power minus 6 multiply t to the power minus 6 divided by 3 to the power minus 10 multiply 5 to the power minus 6 multiply t to the power minus 12. That is equal to 3 to the power minus 4 plus 10 multiply 5 to the power minus 6 plus 6 multiply t to the power minus 6 plus 12. That is equal to 3 to the power 6 multiply 5 to the power 0 multiply t to the power 6. We know that 5 to the power 0 is 1. Therefore, it is equal to 3 to the power 6 multiply 1 multiply t to the power 6. That is equal to 3 to the power 6, t to the power 6 is the answer. Another question. Find the value of x. Minus 5 by 7 to the power minus 4 multiply minus 5 by 7 to the power 12 equal to minus 5 by 7 to the power 3 whole to the power x multiply minus 5 by 7 to the power minus 1. It is an equation. Here we have to find out the value of unknown variable x. So minus 5 by 7 to the power minus 4 plus 12 equal to minus 5 by 7 to the power 3x multiply minus 5 by 7 to the power minus 1, which implies minus 5 by 7 to the power 8 is equal to minus 5 by 7 to the power 3x minus 1, which implies h is equal to 3x minus 1. As we know that a to the power m equal to a to the power n implies m equal to n, which implies 3x is equal to 9 and x is equal to 3, which is the answer. I hope this video is very helpful to you and you will make use of it well. Thank you.